Greetings, this is another video review by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at a new high-output thrower light from Sunwayman, the T40CS. And I think the first thing you'll probably notice, looking at the light, it's obviously a substantial size light. It's obviously designed for throw, given the fairly large head. The other thing though you might notice right off the bat is it looks an awful lot like the Surefire UB3T Invictus, a light I've reviewed recently. In fact, if I pull it out, and pull them side by side, you can see the overall shape and dimensions are quite similar. Especially noticeable is around the grip ring area. Very much the same kind of grip. The tail cap isn't quite the same size. The Invictus is only a 3x CR123A light, whereas the Sunwayman light here is a 4x CR123A. Part of the reason for that is it has a much longer battery tube. But you can see the overall dimensions, you know, and size of the light are similar. Looking at it from different angles. So, an interesting sort of take on the same sort of build. Obviously a few differences. It doesn't have the control ring of the Invictus, nor the optic, but the overall dimensions are actually surprisingly similar. There are, of course, design touches that are distinctive to Sunwayman. I'll let the camera focus up again. One thing is the battery tube. This is very familiar, I find, across a lot of Sunwayman models. What's very distinctive, I think, about this light, in addition to the overall shape and size, is the secondary switch, easily accessible near the head. So let's start with some of the features of this light. First off, you'll see there's a stainless steel bezel ring, flat. I actually prefer a slight crenellation, so you can tell if the light is on. But you know, some people prefer, you know, less of that, or some prefer more. You can see there's a smooth reflector with an XML, in this case, cool white emitter at the base of it. It's a very, very shiny reflector, so they've done a nice job on the polish. There seems to be an anti-reflective coating on the lens, on the glass. All in all, a nice presentation. I'm sure the light will throw quite well. So let's start, I guess, maybe at the tail cap. We'll just open this up. So, fairly traditional looking tail cap. The light uses square cut threads. I don't know how well you can see that in there, anodized for tail cap lockout. It's a two-stage type switch. So the way that this works is you put on the tail cap switch, press it on, and you get a blinding amount of light, as you can see. It's an extremely bright light, as you can tell. You can also see there are beam rings there, as you'd expect for a smooth reflector. It's definitely a high-output thrower light. The way this works is kind of a bit different with the secondary switch. So let me just sort of, again, we'll put this back on. Okay, so you get a lot of light. You can adjust it now from the front switch. So you saw I just turned it on and turned it off by the front switch. Of course, what that now means is actually the light is in standby mode at this point. It's not actually off. It's drawing a small current because this is an electronic switch. You can physically lock it out at the tail cap by clicking it off or turning it a quarter turn. But if you have it turned on and put it into standby mode, you're still drawing a current. Hard for me to measure how much, and I explain this in a little bit more detail in my review on candle power forms. But to give you an idea anyway of how the light works, you press and hold the switch, and it cycles between its three output modes. You let go to select the one you want. So this is low. You see again, there's high, medium, low. And it just cycles back between high, medium, and low. When you find the output you want, you just let go, and it memorizes it. So if you put it back into standby, turn it back on, it stays in low. Of course, it only memorizes it so long as it has power. If you turn the light off, we'll say here at the tail cap, turn it back on, it comes back on in max output. And now again, you have to hold the switch down and get it back down to low. So it works fairly well as long as you don't mind having it in standby when you've turned it off. It also has some strobe modes. If you put it on, double click the light, it comes on in a high output tactical strobe. Double-click again, you get an SOS mode. And you can just cycle back and forth by double-clicking. If you press and hold the switch, it goes back into standard output modes. And again, press and hold, and you can switch between high, medium, and low. So, a lot of options there. Nice to see that the strobe modes are kind of hidden. I actually prefer to see those out of the way. Not something I tend to use very often, but they're there if you want them. My only kind of beef, I guess, is I wish it would remember the light level I want when I click it off the tail cap and put it back on. You don't really have a choice. It always comes on in high right now. Certainly a very solid build. Light opens at both the head and the tail. And I'll show you that part here. And you can see again, those are square cut threads, not anodized for the head. There's a spring in the head, so you can use flat top cells. Basically, overall, a very nice solid build. There's not a lot of knurling per se on the light. There's a bit of knurling on the tail cap, and it's a reasonable aggressiveness. There's the grip ring, which helps for holding the light and giving some extra grip. The body flutes don't really do a lot. Same up here with the head. But because of the differing shape, dimensions, and sizes, overall, I think hand feel and grip is fairly good. There's no obvious lanyard attachment point, which is something else I think that's maybe missing. Some people might like to have. But, you know, all in all, the grip is not bad. It's certainly an attractive looking light, but I think a grip ring would probably help here. For more details on the light, and you can, one thing you can, I mean, it's hard to show in this sort of video review, the throw is excellent. It's a very high output, high thrower light. If you go to my detailed review on Candle Power Forums, you'll see numbers for all that, including runtime estimates, runtime readings, and so forth. So you can find those at candlepowerforums.com in the review forum, the reviews by Selfbuilt, or on my personal website at flashlightreviews.ca. I hope you found that video overview helpful. Thanks a lot.